WrestleMania, the greatest show on earth. This is going to be a chance that I've been waiting for a long time. 12 years ago, I left the WWE, and it left a dirty, rotten, bad taste in my mouth. Left a bad taste in there for years. You know, sometimes even now, I can still taste it. But you know, I got a chance to leave on a good note now. I can leave with my head up, ride high out of the WWE, because I got just what I wanted. I got a match with Vince McMahon, a no-holds-barred match. And that's the greatest news that I could ask for. You know, for years I've heard Vince say, you know, Brett screwed Brett, you know. I'm so sick of hearing that, and all I can do is promise all my fans all around the world that starting next week, all you're going to hear is Brett beat Vince. Brett beat Vince. You know, last week, Vince McMahon, he referred to my family as a bunch of dysfunctional derelicts. You know, all I could say about that is next week in Phoenix, there's going to be more dysfunctional hearts roaming around the streets of Phoenix than you could shake a stick at, because they're all coming down to induct my father into the Hall of Fame. And that's going to be a great night for the Hart family. But Vince McMahon, consider yourself warned, because there's going to be hearts roaming all over town, and you better stay and keep your head low, because I hate to see what my sisters would do to you if they got their hands on you. But you know, Vince McMahon, somehow you managed to drive half your family out of the WWE. But the Harts, all those dysfunctional Harts, they're going to be there in full force because they want to watch me give you the beatdown of your life. Just a couple months ago, Shawn Michaels said, if Bret Hart's allowed to come back to the WWE, good things will happen. Well, he's right. Good things are going to happen. And good things are going to happen next week when I get my hands on Vince McMahon, because I've waited a long, long time to get my hands around that little scrawny neck. And it's going to be a pleasure giving all my fans around the world what they've been waiting for, dreaming for. Just like myself, they want me to get my hands on Vince McMahon, and next week at WrestleMania, I'm going to do that. You know, WrestleMania has always been a special thing for me. You know, I think of the great match I had with Stone Cold Steve Austin, WrestleMania 13. The Iron Man match I had with Shawn Michaels, WrestleMania 12. Even when I won the Intercontinental title from Roddy Piper. I remember the match I had with my brother Owen at WrestleMania 10. And I remember beating Yokozuna for the world title for the third time. Yeah, I've had some great memories at WrestleMania. But I got one promise to make to all my fans right here and around the world. That WrestleMania 26 in Phoenix, Arizona is going to be the best there is, the best there was, and the best there ever will be. And that is a promise. Thank you very much.
Wow. You think he's ready? You think Bret Hart is ready to put 13 years behind him? Finally.
Oh, wait a minute. You didn't think Mr. McMahon was going to let that go unanswered, did you?
Brett, this Sunday, one way or another, you're screwed.
Oh. That's scary.
No chance, or that's what you got.
Ominous words from the boss. No holds barred. Bret Hart versus Mr. McMahon.
I don't like that sneaky smile on the face of the chair.
Sunday at WrestleMania.